A 12-year-old boy has come forward to police over the Surry Hills building inferno a day after two others handed themselves in. More than 100 residents are being kept away from their homes with fears the building's remaining walls could collapse.
On the brink of collapse, surrounded by a sea of bricks, a century of history hanging in the balance.
This front wall that you can see behind me, that has moved 75 mil in.
Another centimetre could send more bricks toppling, keeping fire crews on standby 48 hours into their biggest job in decades. Spot fires still smouldering deep in the debris. The apartments next door a no-go zone. Residents escorted in to pick up essentials.
Just stuff for work, clothing, things like that. Just stuff that we need to, you know, do regular life in the meantime.
Tom and his cat Oddie, rescued by police on Thursday, now staying with friends, unsure when it will be safe to go home again.
They say it's at least 7 days.
The shock still setting in.
I feel the earthquake, kind of like the vibration in the building. I was like, okay, I'm dying.
Neighbours now sharing their brave attempts to tame the ember storm during the peak of the inferno.
A couple of embers flew off and landed on these awnings just next door, so we had to crack the fire hose out and tried our best to spray them.
Cameron and his family doing what they could from the balcony across the road.
It looked like the sky was on fire. It was just crazy. It all landed on our roof up there and burned a couple of our things, burnt the membrane. Got a bit of grass up there, burnt the grass.
So hot.
Randall Street shut off, a tight exclusion zone in place, still too unsafe to hand over to police. A third boy has now handed himself into police, confessing he was inside when the fire started. Detectives are using CCTV from these buildings to close in on more teenage suspects, but are yet to lay any charges over the alleged arson. No missing persons reports have been filed, but the rubble is yet to be searched to confirm that there was no one inside. That will be the top priority once they secure the site with controlled demolition in the next few days. In Surry Hills, Sophie Upcroft, 9 News.